stream. Come and play, everything's A-OK. Friendly neighbors there, that's where we meet. Can you tell me how to get to Sesame Street? How to get to Sesame Street?
I know that street. That's Sesame Street. You know what they really like on Sesame Street? They really like the alphabet.
A is for Athelstan.
B is for Bob.
C is for Cookies! Oh.
D is for David.
E is for Ernie.
Is for Farley.
G is for Gordon.
H is for Hooper.
I is for Ingrid.
J is for Jay.
K is for Kermit.
L is for Luis.
M is for Maria.
N is for Nancy.
O is for Oscar.
P is for Prairie.
Q is for Queen.
R is for Roosevelt.
S is for Susan.
T is for Trey.
U is for Ursula.
D is for Vanessa.
W is for Willie.
X is for Xavier.
Y is for you, and you visit Sesame Street every day.
And Z, well, Z is, you know, I don't think there's anybody on Sesame Street whose name begins with the letter Z. Oh, well, can't have everything.
Say, that's a beautiful D you're building there.
Sure is, isn't it? Look at that nice straight back. And how about this curved front here, huh? Fits perfectly to the back. Okay, boys, take it away.
What are you going to do with this D?
Why, this is the D building here. It's full of everything in the world that begins with the letter D. Here, this floor here is the doll floor. They've already moved some dolls in, I see.
Yes, doll begins with D, doesn't it?
And here's the dog floor. Boy, listen to him bark. D-O-G spells dog, all right.
And this must be the floor with diamonds. Aren't they beautiful?
Wow. Hold your ears. Here's the drum floor.
Drum begins with D, too.
And here's where the ducks and dinosaurs and desks will be, on these floors here. Here we are.
Wait. I know a word that begins with D that you forgot to put in your building.
D.
Dangerous dragon, dee 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 dee, donkey ducky, dinosaur, dee 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 dee, don't drop dishes down on the floor, do a dance, dig some dirt. Dunk a donut for dessert. Draw a daisy that's delightful to see when D is handy. It's fine and dandy. D, 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 D is such a very nice letter. Each day I like it better. That lovely letter called D. You know, there are all kinds of words that begin with the letter D. There's doctor, dentist, and dime, dollar, daddy, door, dandelion, and draw a daisy that's delightful to see when D is handy. It's fine and dandy. D, 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 D is such such a very nice letter. Each day I like it better. That lovely letter called D, 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 D. Having fun, but now I'm D, 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 done.
Dogs dream dreams, do ducks have ears? Do dragons dance? Why do gophers take calls? Do gophers dress up in their dirty clothes?
Dee, dee,
dee. Dogs dream of meat and their dreams are delicious. Ducks do have ears, but they don't do the dishes. Gophers dig holes to hide their candy bars. Dragons don't dance and they don't smoke cigars.
Dee,
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 dee.
Daddy dear, oh daddy sweet, do dandelions roar? Daisies have feet. May I have a drink of water and a dish of tadpoles? Daddy, how deep is a donut hole?
Dee,
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 dee. If dandelions roar, then your daddy is deaf. The daisies drank the water, so the tadpoles left. Your eyes are droopy, darling daughter, and you're dizzy in the head. The toads are eating dinner, so it's time to go to bed. Little Dolly, go to bed.
Okay, well, what you want me here for?
What I want you to do,
yeah,
is take these cookies that are in this bag.
Huh? Cookies!
Four cookies.
Cookies in bag.
Yes.
Look at that.
Yes. Now, I want you to make this plate look the same as this plate.
More cookies. You mean you want me to make this plate
right
here look same as this plate here?
Right. 100% right.
Let's see. Okay. And this cookie, these cookies in bag help me, huh? Okay. Now, okay, me do it. Watch carefully, okay? Me going to make this plate here look exactly same as this plate here.
Good.
Okay?
Good.
Here we go. Oh, cookie! Now watch. Now, see? Oh, wait, we got some cookies. Excuse me, Mr. Hooper. Now, this plate here, exactly same as that plate there. Bye-bye. Oh, sorry. Bye-bye. Anytime me help, you call Cookie.
Down. 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 Down.
This is the letter D. See what it looks like? The letter D is a very useful letter. For example, if you wanted to talk about animals, you could talk about donkeys, deer, dolphins, ducks, doves, Dalmatians, dachshunds, dragons, and dinosaurs. Then, when you grow up, you can be a dancer, a dentist, a detective, druggist, ditch digger, doctor, dishwasher, or a daddy. And in your spare time, you can write in your diary, dress your dolls, dig, draw, drum, or just drop down into the daffodils and daydream. A delightful letter, the letter D.
I
I was taking a walk, walking with my... He's the friendliest that you'll ever see. But we met a furry old... And my funny old... Chased her up a tree. Couldn't get her down, so I found a... And I dialed that, called a friend I knew, told him how my had scared the... She was stuck in a tree. What was I to do? Well, my silly old friend said you'll need a great big with wings to fly. Jump into the, fly up to the, and grab her down as you're flying by. Well, I hung up the, and I heard a, and a big red drove up next to me. A man on the, had a great big ladder. He climbed up to the, got her down from the tree. So I thanked the man. He drove off in the, I called my friend on the, told him things were okay. Said goodbye to the, then I called my, and me and my, we went on our way. And me and my, we went on our way. Come on, Pooch.
Susan.
And Gordon.
Two.
People. David.
Maria.
Two.
People.
Luis and... Luis, two people.
Why are you holding one leg up in the air, Jasper? Because if I hold two legs up in the air, I fall down. Makes sense, sure.
One, two, three, four.
One, two.
Two turtles.
One, two.
Two heads.
One, two.
Two hats.
One, two.
Two butterflies.
One, two.
Two chocolate cream pies.
And I'm from you.
Two ears, one, two. Two eyes, one, two. Two arms, one, two. Two legs, one, two. One bump. Oh, boy.
Hey, does anybody feel like playing a game today?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, let's hear it for a game. You want to hear? You want to play a game?
Yes, you do, Bert.
Oh, come on, Bert.
Come on, Bert.
All right, Ernie. All right.
Let's play a game. You want to play a game?
Yeah.
Okay, now, here's the game that I've got in mind. See, I'm thinking of a lot of things that everybody does. And I want to see how many of those things you can think of that everybody does, okay?
Okay. Uh-huh. Sure, why not?
Okay, now let's see.
I got one.
You got one?
What's that?
People walk.
People walk.
Walk. Everybody walks.
That's good. Everybody walks.
That's true. That's true.
Right.
What'd you say?
Talks.
Talks?
Everybody talks. Talks, yeah.
Everybody breathes? How about that?
Everybody breathes?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Everybody,
I breathe.
Yeah.
Everybody can lift their eyebrows.
Everybody lift their eyebrows. Let's see everybody lift their eyebrows.
I can't lift my eyebrows.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Sorry.
How about eat breakfast? Everybody eats breakfast.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, everybody eats breakfast. That's a good one. That's what I was thinking of, as a matter of fact.
I am?
Yeah. Got any more? I'm thinking of some more.
Everybody yawns.
Everybody yawns? Right?
Hey, you know what? I know something that everybody does.
What's that?
Everybody loves to play in the tubby with their rubber ducky.
No, Ernie. Everybody does not love to play with the rubber duckies in the tubby.
Yeah, no.
Oh, Bert, how can you say that? Why doesn't everybody love to play with their rubber ducky in the tubby?
No, I don't love to.
Got a rubber ducky.
That's right. I don't have a rubber ducky.
Everybody doesn't have one.
I thought everybody had
one. You know what, Ernie?
What, Bert?
I don't want a rubber ducky.
No. Well,
I'll tell you something everybody does love.
Everybody loves
watching my favorite TV show.
What's that?
The Wonderful World of Pigeons.
The Wonderful World of Pigeons?
Doesn't that touch you?
You know what, Bert?
What?
I hate that show.
It's a terrible show.
That's a dull show, Bert.
That is the most exciting hour on TV.
That's an awful show. No, everybody doesn't do that.
They have all pigeons of the world on that show.
Oh, boy.
That's your favorite
ones,
show?
Speckled ones.
Hey, wait a minute. I've never even seen that show. Listen, I've got one more thing in mind, though, that I know everybody does. And I'm gonna do it and see if you can guess what it is,
everybody,
okay?
Your nose,
are you ready?
Okay.
Are you ready?
You ready, Captain?
Oh.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, here we go. This is something everybody does. Watch.
Oh, no, he fell asleep before I can do it. He's sleeping.
Hey.
Hey, we're supposed to be playing a game, Bob.
That's it.
Why are you falling asleep when we're trying to play a game?
Oh.
Everybody sleeps.
Everybody sleeps.
That's it.
That's what I was thinking of.
Everybody sleeps, everybody sleeps. Every night we close our eyes until the morning creeps. All animals and people, every day of the week, like to sleep. How do we know it's so? 'Cause everybody sleeps. There are people who sleep lightly. There are people who sleep sound. There are folks who tuck themselves in bed, and some sleep on the ground. There are people who sleep nightly. There are people who sleep days. But it really doesn't matter, don't you know it's so? 'Cause you sleep in so very many ways. Everybody sleeps, everybody sleeps. Every night we close our eyes until the morning creeps. All animals and people, every day of the week, like to sleep. How do we know it's so? 'Cause everybody sleeps. Everybody sleeps. Everybody sleeps.
Come on in, the door's open.
Excuse me, is this the employment agency?
Oh, yeah, sit down. What do you want?
Well, I was hoping you could find me a job.
Okay, let's see. What's your name?
My name is Teeth.
Teeth?
Yeah, you think you could find a job for me?
Well, let's see. I don't know. We got a couple of jobs open here. Here's one. Oh, we need somebody who can sniff and smell and sneeze. Can you do that,
Oh, gee, no, I'm sorry. I don't do that very well. I have a friend named Nose. That sounds more like her line of work.
Well, too bad. Hey, how are you at hearing? We got a couple of jobs for listening to things. You any good at that,
Oh, sorry. No good at all at hearing. I have a friend in that line of work. Ear is his name. Maybe I'll send him in.
Oh, so, Mr. Teeth, what you're saying is you can't smell or hear. Is there anything you can do, huh?
Well, I can bite and chew things.
That doesn't sound bad. Bite and chew things, yeah. Huh? Okay, how do you do that, Sean?
Well, whenever I see anything to eat, I open wide.
Yeah? Well, and then what?
Then I bite, like this.
Hey, that's my desk. Hey, come on now.
Oh, yeah.
Hey,
very
get my old desk.
It is, too.
Hey, get back away from there. That's my drawer.
Yeah.
Oh, my. Hey, what's up?
Oh,
my telephone's going.
Hey,
my lamp and everything. Everything's going. Hey, what are you doing?
Very tasty.
Hey, come on. Hey, don't do that.
Don't understand
my desk is the only possession I have here. It's not even my office. I rented it from a friend. I didn't rent a bar that I just want you one day. They don't even know I'm here.
Look at those things.
Yeah.
We're going to play three of these things.
Oh, boy. I know
the
answer.
Board. Three of these things belong together.
I know the answer.
Three of these things are kind of the same.
I know the answer.
But one of these things just doesn't belong here.
I got it already.
Now it's time to play our game.
I got it.
You got it?
Sure.
Time to play our game.
All
sure?
These, yeah, three of those things have fur.
One of these things just doesn't belong here.
You have fur.
Tell me. No, I don't.
I have fur.
Did you guess which one?
It's got nice,
did
too.
You guess that this thing doesn't belong here?
No, I didn't.
Did you guess it? You
no.
didn't. Well, you should have because...
That's a car!
Now your song is done!
A car doesn't have fur.
Well, the song's all done. Well, a lot of these things don't have fur. Look again.
The what? Kitty cat has fur.
The kitty cat has fur, right.
Yeah.
But the turtle doesn't have fur.
Oh, poor turtle.
And the elephant doesn't have fur.
Elephant
but
doesn't?
They're all animals. They're
you
all
mean
animals.
The kitty cat and the elephant and the turtle are animals?
That's right. And the car is a vehicle.
A what?
A car.
A vehicle?
Right.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
My pyramid is finished. Hey, Bert, do me a favor. I want to take a picture of this pyramid I built, so while I get my camera, will you make sure nothing happens to the pyramid?
Oh, sure thing, Ernie.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. I just stand here and make sure nothing happens to Ernie's old pyramid.
Greetings. I am the Count.
Hi, Count.
Do you know why they call me the Count? Because I love to count things.
I know.
Ah, look. Blocks. I will count them.
Oh, wait. Those are my friend Ernie's blocks, and he
Silence.
Told me...
I am counting. One, two, three, four. No, I counted that one before. It is difficult to count these blocks in a pile.
Too bad, but you see, Ernie said...
I know what I will do. I will move each block as I count it.
Oh, no. Ernie asked
Silence.
Me to...
One, two, three, four, five, six. Six blocks!
Yes!
Thank you very much.
Oh, boy. Did you see what the Count did? Before I could stop him, he took apart Ernie's pyramid. Oh, boy. I hope Ernie's not upset.
Hello there. I'm ready to take a picture of my... my pyramid.
Yeah.
What happened to it?
He's upset. Ernie, see, the Count was here, and while he counted your blocks, he took your pyramid apart.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
And you let him do it, Bert?
Well...
Greetings. I have decided to count these blocks again.
Now, hold on, Count. Now, these are Ernie's blocks, remember?
Yeah, you just leave those blocks alone.
Yeah.
You're not supposed to touch my blocks.
I am counting. One, two, three, four, five, six, six blocks. Now, what did you want to say?
Ernie wanted to say that you should leave those blocks alone. You should leave things where you find them. Yeah, that's what he wanted to say.
Oh, did I move his blocks?
Yes, you did.
I am sorry. One, two, three, four, five, six, six blocks! Thank you very much.
Well, I sure told him a thing or two, didn't I, Ernie?
Yeah, but Bert...
London Bridge, and I will be the bridge. And you can crawl under the bridge, okay?
Okay.
Okay, here we go now.
Okay.
Oh, London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady. Oh, this is so much fun. Oh, London Bridge, falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge, my fair lady. Keep a smile, keep a smile. All day long, just keep a smile. My fair lady. Oh, somebody's tickling me. Oh, 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 oh. I can't sing if you tickle me. Oh, oh, oh dear. London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down.
My fair lady.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Do you like to imagine you're somebody else, like a doctor or a pilot or a cowboy?
Yeah, and wouldn't it be fun to be a ship captain or a scientist or an acrobat?
But you know, whenever I get to thinking it'd be nicer to be somebody else, I remind myself how nice it is just to be me. Me. Everything I am is me. Everything I see is me in my mirror, me in my bed, me in the pictures I make in my head. Me. What a thing to be is me. Utterly delicious, and since there's no choice, I am sure I and me agree. There's nobody better, sweeter, nicer, smarter, don't you see, than me.
You know, sometimes I remind myself how nice it is to be me, but I remind myself in Spanish. Want to hear?
Sure.
Yo, todo lo que es yo. Todo lo que soy es yo, mi reflejo, yo en el espejo, yo y lo que pasa en mi cabeza, yo. Lo que quiero ser es yo, guapo, formidable y tan buen mozo que estarás de acuerdo. No existe nadie más guapo y cariñoso, ya lo ves, que yo.
It's nice being us, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is. Mm-hmm.
Hey, Oscar. Hmm? What's up?
What do you mean, what's up? The sky is up. You got any other brilliant questions, bright eyes? Look, if you got a lot of questions to ask, you might as well ask this one.
What?
Why don't you ask me if I bought any terrific new hats lately?
Okay. Have you bought any terrific new hats lately?
Odd you should ask. As a matter of fact, I did. I bought a beautiful, terrific hat, the best I've ever seen.
Why, can I?
All us grouches are going to be wearing these hats, going up and down the street.
Well, can I see it?
Well, all right, I suppose. There it is. Look at that.
Hey, that's a dynamite hat.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, you could help put it on if you want.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
How's that?
I thought you said you were going to help put it on.
Well, I am helping, you know. What's wrong?
Well, I want to have it lower. That's the way I like to wear it.
Well, why didn't you say that? I'll put it lower then.
That's right. Pull it down.
Okay. How's that?
No.
That's good. It's perfect.
Mm-mm. No, lower.
Still lower?
Okay.
Right. All right. Yeah, it's almost over your eyes now. That's fine. Here. How's
that? No, it's not fine. Lower.
Oh, Oscar. Mm. How's that?
Hey, perfect. Perfect. That's how I like it.
Perfect?
Yeah.
Oscar, if you walk down the street with your hat over your eyes, you're not going to be able to see anybody.
That's right. And I won't see anybody, and you won't see me, and I don't like hearing people, and that includes you.
The girl is on the blanket. The girl is in the blanket. The girl is under the blanket. The girl is on, in, under the blanket. The girl is on, in, under the blanket. On, on, on. In. Under, under, under.
This is Grover, yeah, and today I'm going to talk to you about heavy and light. Yeah, okay, this is a barbell I have in front of me right here, and this barbell is heavy. Now, I will show you how heavy it is. I will try and lift it. Here we go. Once more. Oh, it is heavier than I thought. Try once more. Enough about heavy today, huh? Let us now talk about light. All right, now come with me. See over here this feather? Now, feathers are light, and this feather is light. Here, I will pick it up and show you. See, I will pick up this feather. Wait a minute. Why can I not pick up this feather? This feather is supposed to be light. Why is it not light?
Because this feather is attached to me, and I'm heavy.
I give up.
One, two. Two turtles.
One, two.
Two hens.
One, two.
Two hats.
One, two.
Two butterflies.
One, two.
Two chocolate cream pies.
And I'm going to find you.
Well, I decided to go there anyway to do it.
Well, what is that?
Thank you.
Greetings, humans.
Who are you?
I am a super automatic machine. You may call me by my initials, S-A-M, Sam.
Sam?
What kind of machine are you?
I am a machine that would be anything you like. What kind of machine do you want? I can do anything. Machines are better than people.
Can't believe this.
I can't even. Look at this.
Machines can do anything. I can be an adding machine, subtracting machine, gumball machine, soda pop dispensing machine, jukebox music.
All right, okay.
Okay, we get the idea. Right.
Yes. And what is more, I never make a mistake. I am a machine, and machines are perfect. Are perfect. Are perfect. Are perfect. Thank you.
What are you doing here on Sesame Street?
You are wrong. This is Mulberry Street. This is not Sesame Street.
No, no, Sam, I'm sorry. You're wrong. This is Sesame Street.
You are wrong. I am programmed to go to Mulberry Street. I am here. This is Mulberry Street.
You know something, Sam? Maybe you never make mistakes, but you're wrong this time. You goofed, man. This is Sesame Street.
That's right.
I will read out my program again. What street is this?
Look at the lights going.
This isn't a fan down there. There's one over there. The eyes.
Listen to all those noises. Street.
Yes, you see? Well, I have to go, humans. I am meeting a cement mixer for lunch, and machines are never late. They are perfect, are perfect, are perfect, are perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sam?
Yes?
Isn't it a little unusual to meet a cement mixer for lunch?
Yes, it is. Usually, we meet for dinner. I cannot talk any longer. It must be time for me to meet my friend. Please, read out my clock.
Oh, Sam, I can't. It's going forward too fast.
I will make that correction.
Oh, boy, terrific. Now it's going backwards too fast.
You see, machines are perfect. We never make a mistake. We are perfect, are perfect, are perfect, are perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, is that the sound of a cement mixer?
Yeah, there's one over there.
Oh, I can stay no longer. I must go. Excuse me. Shirley, wait for me.
What?
I just thought of something terrible.
What's that?
This is Sesame Street.
I know this is Sesame Street.
But he thinks it's Mulberry Street.
So what?
And surely the cement mixer is waiting for him on Mulberry Street.
Yeah, so?
Well, he's chasing a perfect stranger.
Danny knows the alphabet, and is he proud? If you can follow him, then sing out loud.
A, B. C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Alphabet! Alphabet! Rah, rah, rah!
And now it's time for everybody's favorite reunion show, Here Is Your Life. And here is your life host, Guy Smiley.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Here Is Your Life,
I'm Guy Smiley, and I'm here in the forest disguised as a tree so I can surprise our Here Is Your Life guest. Here I go. Shh. Excuse me, are you an oak tree?
Why, yes, I am. Who are you? Maple tree? Birch?
No, I'm not a tree at all. I'm Guy Smiley, and oak tree, here is your life.
Oh no.
Yes.
No, you're kidding.
No, we're not me. Yes.
Oh, what a surprise.
Yes, oak tree, you've had a wonderful life, a life that began right here on this very spot. So listen, oak tree, and tell us if you can remember this voice.
I can still remember oak tree when he was just a little acorn.
Oh, no. That's not...
Yes, that's the person who planted you in the ground when you were just an acorn, all the way from the farmhouse down the road, Granny Fanny Nestle Road!
Granny, it's so nice to see you.
Tell us, Granny Fanny, was oak tree really cute back then?
Well, see for yourself. Here's a picture of him just before I planted him in the ground. He was just an adorable little acorn then.
Aww.
Well, thank you very much, Farmer Fanny.
I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for her.
There's more to your wonderful life. Listen to this voice.
Hi, oak tree. Remember me? I helped you grow. I know that voice.
Yes, I bet you do, oak tree. And listen to this voice also.
Hi, oak tree. You couldn't have grown without me.
Oh, no. It couldn't be.
Yes, it is. It's the cloud and the sun. Come on out here, cloud.
Oh, my old friend.
Look at that.
Hiya, tree. How you doing?
Oh,
wonderful. Can you tell us, cloud and sun, how did you all help the oak tree to grow?
Well, Guy, I rained on him so he'd have water.
And I shined on him.
Yes. That's right. I couldn't have grown without them. He remembers.
That's just wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you, Cloud and Sun. Thank you very much for coming out here and being on our stage.
Oh, this is too much.
And so, oak tree, you grew along with the other trees around you.
Yes.
And you were happy. And then one day, some people came and cut down two of the trees that grew nearby.
Oh, yes.
Those two trees were your friends.
Oh.
You haven't seen them in years.
No.
But we found them. They used to be trees, but now they're a table and a chair. Here they are, all the way from Sausalito, California. Marty Table and Sarah Chair. Come on out here, Marty and Sarah.
Oh, this is...
Oh, what a wonderful
moment.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes, oak tree, this is it. From little acorn to large, beautiful tree. It's been our pleasure to bring you and your friends together on Here Is Your Life.
Marty, Sarah, oh,
and also, we're going to have for you a beautiful charm bracelet to remember this occasion. There's going to be a party in the forest with all of your friends. There's going to be fertilizer for everyone. The leaves will be there, the bushes from nearby, all the little bitty rabbits.
My old friends, Granny.
Join us again
Son,
for another visit to
Say, that's a beautiful D you're building there.
Sure is, isn't it? Look at that nice straight back. And how about this curved front here, huh? Fits perfectly to the back. Okay, boys, take it away.
What are you going to do with this D?
Why, this is the D building here. It's full of everything in the world that begins with the letter D. Here, this floor here is the doll floor. They've already moved some dolls in, I see.
Yes, doll begins with D, doesn't it?
And here's the dog floor. Boy, listen to him bark. D-O-G spells dog, all right.
And this must be the floor with diamonds. Aren't they beautiful?
Wow. Hold your ears. Here's the drum floor.
Drum begins with D, too.
And here's where the ducks and dinosaurs and desks will be, on these floors here. Here we are.
Wait, I know a word that begins with D that you forgot to put in your building.
Wanna hear a beautiful sounding word? Warthog. Yeah, warthog. 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 What a beautiful sounding word. And a beautiful animal, too. Warthog.
These are the letters U and N. Together they sound like this. Un. Way back there is the letter R. The letter R sounds like this. Un. Run! That's run!
Run! Run!
Hey, look at him run!
Oh, run!
Look at him run! 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 Look at him run!
Run! Run!
Behind me, there are two doors, here and here. And the letter E is above both of the doors. See him, huh? Do you? All right. I'll bet you're wondering what those two letter E's are doing up there, don't you? Huh? Well, E is a very important letter because it is the first letter in the word enter. And it's the first letter in the word exit. So you see, the letter E is very... That's enough, Roy. Well, kids, that's it. The letter E. Stop it, Roy. Roy, you're really weird.
Waiter,
sir.
Waiter, I'd like
be
to order.
Patient. One moment. Yes, sir, I'm ready now. What can I do for you?
Yes, I'd like a bowl of chicken soup, please.
Very good choice. You've been here before, haven't you? I'll be right back. One bowl of chicken soup, Charlie.
That settles it. I don't know why I keep coming back to this place. This guy gives me a hard time every time I come in here. If it's not one thing, it's another.
Here, Charlie. Okay, sir. Here we have your delicious chicken soup.
Yes. Waiter!
Yes, sir.
I can't eat this soup.
You can't eat this soup? Why can't... Oh, of course not. I can feel it. It is too cold. I will get you another bowl of soup. I'm sorry, sir.
No, that...
Hey, Charlie, how about a hot bowl this time, okay? Give the guy a break.
Well, that settles it. From now on, I'm bringing my lunch to work in a paper sack.
Okay, Charlie, I think you'll be happy this time. There you are, sir.
Now, I...
Have a good and hearty meal.
Yes, but... Waiter!
Oh, I bet it's too hot now. Okay, I'll blow on for you.
The problem is, you
there,
see,
there,
you
there,
forgot
there,
to bring...
Well, I forgot the salt, didn't I? Of
no.
course. The pepper.
No.
The crackers.
No, no, no.
Well, then tell me, why can't you eat the soup, sir?
Why don't you taste it?
Oh, all right, sir. The customer is always right. I shall taste it. Where's the spoon?
Aha!
Oh, I forgot the spoon. Oh!
You can't eat soup without a spoon.
I'm so sorry, sir.
Wow.
There's the spoon.
Now.
Next time, when you want the spoon, ask for one.
What if a frog had a fly's wings and the fly's eyes and the fly's head and the fly's hairy body and the fly's legs? Now then, what if the fly had frog's legs and a frog's head, and last but not least, a frog's body? What do you think would happen?
Oh, my fair lady. Oh, that was so much fun. Hey, I'm very tired now. I think I better go home. Would you like to walk me to my cave?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Here we go.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letter D and by the number 2. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Whatever that is.